Good morning, class. Today I'm going to start with nutrition in animals. The last time we did nutrition in plants, if you remember, and then based on that we classified the plants into autotrophs. But all plants are not autotrophs, so we said there are some plants that depend upon other organisms for food. Do you remember? They were saprotrophs. They had symbiotic relationship. They are parasitic, and they depend on, so they are insectivores, right? But when we talk of animals, they require food, so they are all heterotrophs, and the mode of taking food is different in different organisms. So in this chapter we are going to deal with nutrition in animals. The animals could be humans also, the animals could be ants, birds, eagles, and so on, and the animal could be a cow, right? So the objectives of this chapter are, you will be able to list the various life processes, explain the term digestion, distinguish between milk teeth and permanent teeth, and explain the human digestive system. So the various life processes are, you all remember, you did this in class 5 also, 4 also, it's only a extension to that. Nutrition, respiration, excretion, growth, reproduction, and response to a stimulus. So the focus will be today on nutrition. So there are various modes of feeding which is shown by birds, mosquitoes, ant, snail, etc., because they don't have a well-defined digestive system. So sometimes they are scraping food, sometimes they are capturing food, sometimes they are swallowing food, they are chewing food, and they are sucking blood, sucking food, right? So the food is also different for different organisms, and the mode of taking this food is also different. Now, what is animal nutrition? It will include the nutrient which is required, the mode of intake of the food by an organism, and how it is utilized by the body. Unless and until the food is utilized by the body, it's not going to give any benefit to the person. Sometimes you must have seen that you eat quite well, but still you don't grow properly. You suffer from diseases. The result is, this is because you are taking in the food, but some mechanism is wrong somewhere, as a result of which the body is not utilizing that food. So utilization is equally important. You have taken your nutrient, the nutrients there that are needed by the body, if you remember, carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Along with that, roughage and water. How do you take it? In our case, how do we take it? Through our mouth. We pick up the food, we put it in our mouth. But there are so many organisms who can't do that. So how do? They suck it, they swallow it, they chew it, they grasp it, right? So there are different modes of taking food, and then how the body is utilizing them. So there are different steps which are involved in taking in of food in our case. The first one is called ingestion, the act of taking in of food. Digestion, absorption, assimilation, and finally excretion or ejection.
Kindly pay attention, gentlemen, sir, and drop the mic, sir.
Steps,
please send all my private students to this toilet number 3.
How do we repeat?
All private students to report to toilet number 3. Rohit Patanik sir and Chakravarti sir, please wait.
How is the food broken down into
smaller and I request all the teachers to please inform transporting charges. How many times do you require to go to finalize the list or to to call the children for the next routing time?
The process of taking in of this food by the small intestine, how it is assimilated by the body, and finally how the waste is removed. So all these 5 processes are important in nutrition, and in a human being we have a proper digestive system where each part is responsible for a particular step. So this questionnaire I'll come in the end. Once I'm through with the chapter, I'll move on to the next slide. This is our digestive system. So we've got a well-defined digestive system. Do you know where this digestive system starts from? Yes, it starts from our mouth, and it includes the ingestion, movement, mechanical and chemical digestion, absorption, and assimilation and elimination or egestion. There are different terms that they use, more or less there are these five processes. So we have this system. This system is the digestive system. This is also called a GI tract. This tract starts from this part of our mouth. It is going towards the stomach. Then this is the intestine, the small intestine, the large intestine, the pancreas, liver, and the gallbladder. You did this digestive system in class 5 also, but every year we have this system till class 12 also, but every year there is a extension and some more details about it. Nothing will change about our body, it's going to be the same, but it's only the processes will increase, the functions will increase, the organs will increase, and that is all. So this is the structure. We have the mouth, the pharynx, the esophagus, the stomach, small intestine, large intestine, and the rectum, finally the anus. So this is the mouth, the pharynx, this is the esophagus, the stomach, this red stomach, the small intestine, this pink color, the large intestine, and the rectum. So we start with mouth. What are we doing? We are taking food, morsels of food, we bring it to our mouth. And then begins the function of our teeth. What is the teeth doing? It is breaking down the food into simpler substances. It is helping us to swallow. We have the salivary glands here. The salivary glands are helping in bringing the moisture, the mucus, the liquid part, so that the food can go into a small pipe, which is the esophagus. So teeth is mechanically breaking down the food into small pieces. Tongue is mixing the food with the saliva. This contains amylase, which helps in breakdown of the starch. Now what is amylase? These are the various enzymes. So we have certain, you know, helpers. These are the chemicals which are helping. They are not acting themselves, but they are easing down the process. So they are called enzymes. They act upon the substance, help in breaking down of that substance. Then there is a epiglottis, which is a flat-like structure at the back of the throat that closes over the trachea, preventing food from entering it. It is located in the pharynx. Actually, we have the two pipes, the food pipe and the windpipe. They are running parallel to each other, right? So sometimes you are not very careful while you are eating food. Sometimes you tend to lie down and you eat food. You are talking and eating food. You are going down during the break time and eating food. In that case, the two pipes are so close by that the chances of the food going into the windpipe increases. And what will happen if the food goes into the windpipe? Then you can't breathe. And you can't stay without breathing even for 5 to 10 seconds. You get so uncomfortable. So these are the mechanisms that help us so that the food does not go into the windpipe when you are eating. Still at times it happens that the food goes into the windpipe. And sometimes you must have seen your mother, she'll put her hand at the back and the food might come out. Or you might cough and the food comes out. Or you might drink water and the food goes down. So these are some of the mechanisms that the body shows so that the food goes into the right track. Then we have this esophagus. Now this esophagus is the pipe which is connecting, this green color, which is connecting the mouth to the stomach. It's a small pipe, and this pipe is approximately 20 centimeter long. The functions include, it secretes mucus, moves the food from the throat to the stomach using the muscle movement, which is called peristalsis, or it's called peristaltic movement. It is that movement which is helping the food to go down into the stomach. Otherwise, it's a narrow pipe, and when you're eating, do you ever realize when you're eating the whole burger that this has to go through this narrow pipe? So it is because of this peristaltic movement that the food reaches the stomach. If acid from the stomach gets in, that's a heartburn. Sometimes it happens that you are very hungry and you eat in a hurry. Sometimes you're very tense and you go on eating and eating and eating. Sometimes the food is very tasty. It's fried food when you like it. So you go on eating. As a result, there is overeating, and the acid content in the body increases. So then what happens? This food is coming out. How is this food coming out? It is coming out through the esophagus only, and it comes out through the mouth. What is it called? It's called vomiting. Why do we vomit? Because of the acid content which increases in the stomach. Which acid is present in the stomach? Yes, it's called hydrochloric acid. You know, some amount of hydrochloric acid is also present in the toilet cleaners. Very small amount, but it's present. The same acid, but in very small amount. If the quantity of that acid increases, then that results in what is called a heartburn or acidity. Now comes the stomach. The stomach is this red colored, and this you can see the detailed part of the stomach. This stomach is a J-shaped muscular bag that stores the food you eat, breaks it down into tiny pieces. This mixes the food with the digestive juices that contain enzymes to break down the proteins and lipids. What are enzymes? These are the chemicals that help in digestion. They themselves do not get converted into any compound, but they ease out the process. The acid which is present in the stomach is hydrochloric acid, HCl, and this helps in killing the bacteria. Because when you are eating, sometimes the hands are dirty, sometimes the food might be contaminated, sometimes the germs go inside while breathing. So this enters the food canal. Now if all these germs are going to stay in our body, they can cause diseases. So for that, we have this acid which is present in our stomach. It is needed in a small quantity, but if this quantity increases, that is a problem. Now this is the next part, which is the small intestine. It's called a small intestine, though it is very long. This is the pink part that you see. This is the small intestine. It is 7 meters long. Lining of the intestine wall has finger-like projections, which are called villi. They increase the surface area. So these are the villi. This is how they are made, something like your finger. This is a villi. The same area is to have a 7 meter. It's going from one end of your room to the other. So just to squeeze in into a small area, there are finger-like projections inside the small intestine. It's occupying a small area, but it is larger in size. Whereas the large intestine is occupying a large area and is small in size. Right? So this is 7 meters long, and it has villi, and this helps in absorption of the food. I'll come to the various steps again. The villi are covered in microvilli, which further increases the surface area for absorption. Nutrients from the food pass into the bloodstream through the small intestine wall. It absorbs 80% of the ingested water, vitamins, minerals, carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, and secretes digestive enzymes. So this is how our small intestine looks like. Then we have the large intestine, this brown color. This is 1.5 meters long, except what small intestines don't absorb. Rectum is a short-term storage which holds the feces or the waste which is generated before it is expelled. So moving on with the, these are the glands which are apart from the organs. We have certain glands also present in our system. This is a liver. This is the largest gland of our body. Directly affects the digestion by producing bile. Bile helps in digestion of fat. It filters out the toxin and waste including drugs and alcohol and poison. Next is the gallbladder. This gallbladder is present inside. You can see this small part here. This is the gallbladder. The liver is secreting the bile, but this bile is stored in gallbladder, releases it into the small intestine. Fatty diets can cause gallstone. So you could have a stone there that pains and it has to be removed from the body. Then the third is a pancreas. This pancreas again is going to, this yellow part that you see, a leaf-like structure, this is the pancreas. This pancreas will also give out the juices, produces digestive enzymes to digest fat, carbohydrate and proteins, regulates the blood sugar by producing insulin. Now it's quiz time. I'll again do a recap. You just have to tell me the various parts of each of these colored organs. This green is, yes, you're right, green is the esophagus. Red is the stomach. Pink is the, this one is the small intestine. Brown is the large intestine. Then purple, where is the purple? This is liver. Green, a gallbladder. And yellow is the pancreas. So I'll repeat again, the food is entering through the mouth. The mouth has the teeth. The teeth are divided into two types, the milk teeth and the permanent teeth. Again, the teeth are of various shapes and sizes. I'll come to that. Then we have the esophagus. This is the tube which is connecting the mouth to the stomach. This is helping the food to go in through peristaltic movement. In case there is extra acid produced, the acid will come out through your mouth as a vomit. Then is the stomach, a J-shaped bag. This bag helps in majorly the process of digestion takes place here. So ingestion was here, the first step in the mouth. Here you have digestion. The food is digested, broken down into various smaller pieces. It is acted upon by the bile, which is given by the liver, because the bile is produced here, stored in the gallbladder. It's given out in the stomach. Then we have the pancreas that gives out the pancreatic juices, and then we have the acid, the hydrochloric acid. So the major part of digestion takes place in the stomach. Then the food reaches the small intestine, where there are finger-like projections which are called villi. These villi help in increasing the area so that absorption, the third step, takes place here. The food is absorbed here. How will you get energy? Unless the food is not absorbed by the body, unless the food is not broken down into simpler substances and the same components are not again combined. So that is what takes place here. All the waste is given out in the large intestine, whatever the small intestine is not absorbing, and it is stored in rectum till the time it is given out through the anus. So excretion, the last step. Assimilation is the step where the digested food after absorption is again combined into complex substances. All proteins will be combined together, all fats will be combined together, and they will be passed through the bloodstream so that the body can get energy. So ultimately, what is the aim? That you take in food, the food is taken and accepted by the body, and it gives out energy to do the various life processes. So this is what we did. The digestive system, First, green is the esophagus, red is the stomach, pink is the small intestine, brown is the large intestine, purple is the liver, green the gallbladder, and yellow the pancreas.
So, all the teachers are requested to send the students back to their original classrooms, to their classes sections. I repeat, so all the teachers are requested to send the students back to their classes and sections.
You want to see how we
do the classes sections.
Just see.
And they will not like to just adhere to them.
This is how the food moves. This is how your food, the morsel that you've eaten, is moving through this path.
When you change, the teachers provide a group till 10:25. Then after the group will be there at 10:25. Please ask them to write to the classes.
This is a villi. This is what finger-like projection is. So this is how a small intestine is designed, so that maximum absorption of food takes place. This is the food which is coming. Isn't it exciting? We never thought when we eat something that the food has to go through so much processes. See how this food has entered, how it will be absorbed, how the unabsorbed food, so we have the red and the blue. What is this? This is the artery and this is the vein. So this is how the food will be absorbed here, and all the unabsorbed food will go here. Now it is coming here. Now it is leaving here. It is stored here. This unwanted food is stored here. Whenever we are doing any work, maybe you do some craft work, you are creating something, you are creating, most of the time the waste is created. And this waste has to be removed from the body. What if it is not removed from the body? It's going to create problems. So this is what happens. So this is as far as our system is concerned. See the arrangement, the placement of our teeth. Just see how they are arranged in our skull. So we have a set of 20 teeth when you are born. These are the milk teeth, doodh ke daant. But after that we have the permanent teeth. And there are various sizes and shapes. Those are called permanent teeth. So we have a variety of teeth depending upon the function that they have to perform. As a child, you have the same. See how they are arranged? How they are arranged here? Therefore, dental and oral cleanliness is so important, because anything happens to them, the tooth will get affected. What is that called? It's called tooth decay. They will start giving out acid. They will decay. See how they are connected. Each and every has a blood vessel. Isn't it interesting to see how complex our systems are? Without knowing, we just go on eating chocolates and ice cream. We don't even rinse our mouth, and everything gets collected here. And there comes a time when it starts paining, and there comes a time when you have to get it extracted, get it removed, because you have a cavity here. The tooth starts decaying, and ultimately what happens, you have to get it extracted. So instead of doing that, why can't we take care of our teeth? They're so important. They have to live all our lives. Even when we die, you know, that this part, the hardest part, it stays there, doesn't get burnt also. So it is that hard a part, and we hardly take any care of our teeth. So we have two kinds of teeth, the milk teeth and the permanent teeth. Milk teeth are 20 in number, 10 here and 10 here, and they are of the same type. So by the time, what time do you think your first teeth comes? First tooth comes at the age of 6 months, sometimes 4-5 months. And by the time you are 2.5 to 3 years old, all the teeth, almost 18 to 20 teeth are there. After that, they start coming out, falling out, and by the time you grow as, say, 14 or 15, you have a pair of, not a pair, you have almost 32. They say 32, but it's not there, because now we have got shorter jaws. So we have 15 teeth here and 15, that makes it 30. And then they are divided into four types. They are the incisor, the canines, the molars and the premolars. So the detail of this I'll discuss in the next class. So with this, can we have a small quiz now so that whatever you understood, we can at least have a quick recap. So this quiz we already had. So the next is this quiz. Okay, this is a questionnaire. What is nutrition? Yes, taking in of food and utilization by the body. Function of tongue, it helps in rolling down the food and bringing it inside. The finger-like projection in the small intestine, villi. The four taste buds, they are sweet, sour, salty and bitter. The finger-like projections in an amoeba, this we've not done, we do it. Differentiate between excretion and egestion. Excretion is only removal of solid waste, whereas egestion you have the solid, liquid and the gaseous waste. Which part in amoeba? Again we read that. Define the process of ingestion, taking in of food, digestion, breaking down of food into simpler substances. The part of the system that helps in absorption of water, large intestine, storage of bile, gallbladder, absorption of food, small intestine, production of bile, liver, and ingestion of food, mouth. So with this, we come to the end of this chapter.